welcome to Beauty Essentials Teachings. Please don't forget to like our videos, subscribe on our YouTube channel, place your comment to let us know what you like and what you don't like about our videos. Today we are going to be doing a cow hand dress. This is going to be a long gown, more like a maxi dress. And the measurement that we need here, they are not much. We need the shoulder measurement, we need the gown length, we need the hips and the cow length. When I mean the cow length, the hand of the cow hand, the length of the cow hand. Now let's go to the table. I will explain why the shoulder is 21. Now for this dress, I'm going to be using a boat neckline. And note that depending on how big the person that you're making the dress is for. Now this person's hip is 44, so and divided by 4, I have 11 plus 3 inches because it's going to be a bit of maxi. We have 14 here. Now I'm using 3 yards because the person is a bit big, and actually the person wants the hand, the cow hand, to be very big. Now I said we are using a boat neckline, so now I have 5 inches width and 3.5 inches depth. I have 5 inches width, 3.5 inches depth. Sorry, I've already marked it. I had a slight glitch on the camera. So this is it here. This is five inches width and 3.5 inches depth. Now let's go to the shoulder line. Now before you, at the shoulder line, you're going to be doing a shoulder slant. Now because of how lengthy this is going to be, I'm using 21 at the shoulder side. This is going to be the shoulder, the sleeve is 21, and right here is our 21. Now on that 21, we are going to do our shoulder slant. I'm using 3 inches as the shoulder slant. So I'll connect from the edge of the neckline to the shoulder, edge of the neckline to the shoulder. That's our shoulder slant. I hope to God you can see this marker. Please, if you're doing it on your dress, don't use a marker, use a chalk, use a colored chalk that can show on your dress and not a permanent, though this is not a permanent marker. And I'm going to be cutting out these areas. Now with that out of the way, we're going to try to get the cow. Remember I told you that the reason why I have a length for a cow length is because the person wants the cow to be very full. Now I have 27 inches for the cow. Some people do 22, some people do 20, depend on how big you want the cow to look. This one is going to be very big. It's going to come down to the hip side. Now I mark my 27 from the shoulder slant. I mark 27 here. Now where my 27 is, remember I told you that the hip line is 14 inches. So from where we marked our cow hand, that's where we are going to be using as the hip line. Now the hip line is 14 inches, including the seam allowance. Okay, I'm going to add extra 1 inch for the seam allowance because it's going to be a very maxi. So I'm using 15 inches to mark. Now I'm going to give it a slight curve here. Now that's 15 inches that I use is what I'm going to use for the length. The length of the gown is 60. So I'll drag this down so we can get the length of the gown. The length of the gown is 60, so I keep marking 15 down. And then when I get to the length, I'll mark 16 so that there will be a little, to be a bit free for the person to be able to walk. Sorry, our table is not very very long, so this is 16 here. Now that's 16. We're going to mark 16 to the end. Now let's go back to the cow side. But before we go back to the cow side, there's something we need to do here to help it have a curve. So I'm going to use this curve ruler, place it here. If you don't have a curve ruler, you can use your hand to make the curve. See that? So when you are sewing it, it will not give you difficulty. If you do that there, you do that here too. You do that here and do the same thing over here. clean. Now we have our cow dress. This is what our cow dress will look like. Let's cut it out. Everybody has a different way they sew it. This is a chiffon dress. It's always stressful to keep it from shaking. So if you have pin, you can always pin it down. This is back and front together. I am cutting out the neckline. Then I'll cut the shoulder slant out. Then I'll follow this curve this way to the other curve too. See that? Now I have to come this way so that there won't be any confusion at all. So I'm cutting from the length now. To manage this, please don't forget to subscribe on our YouTube channel, follow us on our other social media handles, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter at Essential Stitches, and also comment on our videos and tell us what you think we're not doing right and other kind of dresses that you would like us to make. So what we are going to do now is you take this to the table. Okay, sorry, forgot something. Okay, now this is what I usually do. To get the armhole, you know where your hand, your sleeve is going to be coming out from. Where's my mark? Okay. So I'll mark from here. I'll do 14 inches. Depending, some people do 12. If you don't want it to be resting, if you don't want the sleeve to be too long, so okay, for the sake of this video, we are going to be using 13 inches. So we mark 13 from here, we mark 13 here. Okay, this way. So from this 13, now we're going to mark 10. That's going to be where our sleeve is. That's 10 inches. Notch it and notch this way and notch this way. Now when you are sewing, now this is our sleeve. This is where your hand is going to come in. When you are sewing, let me open it so that this is what your neckline will look like. Remember, it's two dress lines here, the front and the back. So when you take it to the sewing table, all you need to do is you sew from here to the 13 or 12 or 14, whatever you used. You leave this place open. It's either you're going to whip it or you're going to use a bias to turn it, depending on what you want. Then from here, you run it all the way down. Do the same thing to the other side. That's it, you have your cow hand. So I'm going to show you my finished product when I'm done. Thank you so much. I don't mind if you show me yours on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, any of them at Essential Stitches. Please also follow us on those accounts that I just mentioned. Please don't forget to like us on our YouTube channel and subscribe. It's free, subscription is free. And also don't forget to always wash your hands, follow every instruction given by the doctor and the government so we can help stop the coronavirus in Nigeria. I love you so much. Let me know if there are other videos you want me to, other tutorials you want me to do. And also let me know if I'm talking too fast or slower this time. If you have more understanding of what I am teaching, also let me know. I love you so much. Take good care of yourself.